have lighters on my dresser, and yes, sir. You know I got to get paid. A 25 lighters on my dresser, and yes, sir. You know I got to get paid. Lighters for my 25 folks. Gonna break the bank with 25 more. About to rip the suits with 25 flows. I got 25 lighters, well, don't you know?
Hi, this is Ken Kaplan from the New England Motorcycle Museum, and I'm proud to be representing what I think is probably the finest 77 Superglide shovel head left in existence, at least on the East Coast here. This is an original 6,000 mile, one owner, pristine original example of the Superglide. Purchased right here in Berlin, Connecticut. I have the original certificate of title from the one owner bike. It was bought at Harley Davidson Sales of Berlin, Connecticut by Gary Sadlowski, who owned it for 40 years. It took me 2 years to pry this thing from his hands, and I've had it for about a year and a half now. We've gone through the bike front to back. I know the bike, every square inch of this bike has been carefully examined and serviced. We had our point with this bike was to pay special attention not to mess with the patina of this bike. We did not touch up the paint job on the tank and tins at all, nor did we touch up the frame or the engine or anywhere on the bike. The only spot that we put paint on this motorcycle was the swing arm, because the paint on the swing arm had chipped off and it had a little bit of rust starting on the swing arm, just surface rust on the metal. So we repainted the swing arm, but the rest of the bike is 100% original. The intake and exhaust, very rare to find a 40-year-old Harley in 100% original condition. Some of the service items on it are brand new, like the tires. They're absolutely brand new Dunlop Elite 2s. We just put about 46 hours of labor into this bike, between detailing and servicing. I'll explain everything we did to the bike to you in a moment. Again, I've got the original, not only the title in hand, but I also have the original owner's manual, which is kind of a cool thing to have. 40-year-old owner's manual. Both the title and manual are in pristine condition, like the motorcycle is well cared for. This bike, again, 6,149 original tires. We just put a total of $7,495 into the motorcycle on top of what we paid for it. So this is a substantial investment in the bike. The NADA number one value of this bike is $13,675. The new edition's coming out this month. They're probably gonna go up a bit. It'll be just over $14,000. And I would value this one at higher than that because of the condition and the provenance and the fact that it's a one owner bike. I'd say this bike's worth somewhere around $17,000. I mean, where are you gonna find, anybody can go to the Harley dealer, plunk down 17, 18 grand on a new Superglide. 5 years from now, it's worth half that. 10 years from that, now they're worth $5,000. This is a classic vintage Harley that's going up in value, and where are you gonna find another one like it? This has a Kickstarter on it, and it is fantastic. It's one of the quietest shovel heads, if not the quietest shovel head I've ever ridden, and we have a lot of these come through the New England Motorcycle Museum, shovel heads and iron heads and pan heads. This one is super, super smooth. Without the work we did on it, obviously, the carburetor, it took us 3 tries. It's original carburetor on this bike to get it tuned to perfection. It has original intake, original exhaust. The brakes, everything's been gone through on the bike front to back. The brakes are on point with these brand new Dunlop tires. This thing, they call it a super glide for a reason. This thing just glides down the road. It handles great, shifts perfectly. I'll go through everything we did with the bike after I've done one for you. It's just a fantastic motorcycle front to back. The bottom of the motorcycle, if you look at the frame rails on the bottom here, they're as clean as the top of the motorcycle. Never paintbrush has never been touched on there. It's all original. Everything on the bike's in beautiful shape. I'll let me bring for a quick demo ride, and then I'll come back and I'll go over the service work order. I have a 3-page work order of everything we did to this motorcycle to get it in the shape it's in. Right up,
purrs like a kitten. Probably didn't run this good the day it came out of the factory. This thing's perfectly tuned. Just like it too. Perfectly reliable, has no issues whatsoever. Everything works perfectly on this motorcycle.
Let me give you a quick demo of it.
Across the street. All the lights, all electrical components, everything on the motorcycle is in perfect order. The high beam, low beam, turn signals, brake lights, tachometer, speedometer, everything's perfect like you'd expect a museum quality motorcycle to be. I'm gonna hop off right here. I'll do a couple of drive-bys, get it up to fourth gear, cruise by. Would you see how smooth and quiet this machine is? Glides down the road. Shifts perfectly, accelerates beautifully, carbureted perfectly, the brakes are on point and it handles really nice. The seat's comfortable, the suspensions have been all rebuilt. I'll go over that with you when I get inside, when I go over the work order. Just a fantastic motorcycle. You're not going to find a finer 40-year-old Harley anywhere this side of the Harley-Davidson Museum. It's on display in the New England Motorcycle Museum today if you want to come take a look at it. We're here Monday through Friday, 9 to 5. So we just got back from the test ride on this bike, and it is absolutely fantastic. As you can see in the video, it runs like a brand new motorcycle. It's one of the quietest shovel heads I've ever ridden, and we've just gone through this bike front to back. A total of 46 hours were invested into the labor of servicing and detailing this motorcycle. Again, no paint work has been done anywhere on this bike except for the swing arm. It's all 100% original AMF Harley-Davidson classic vintage bike. In pristine condition. The starting at the front of the bike, the whole front end was dismantled from the motorcycle. All the bearings in the front end here were adjusted and clean, lubed. The forks were dismantled. Brand new fork seals and fork rubbers were installed. The fork oil was changed, and the forks were detailed top to bottom. While the front end was off, the rim was dismantled. The brand new Dunlop Elite 2 tire was put on there. You can see it still has the hairy nubs on it. It's got a hairy dog on it too right now, but back off, bud. Brand new Dunlop tire. The brake system was thoroughly serviced on the front here. Everything was dismantled, all the pins were cleaned, lubed where they needed to be lubed, and the DOT5 oil fluid was drained, flushed, master cylinder was rebuilt, and new fluid was put in, and it was bled. So the whole front ends were completely serviced. Throttle was removed, cleaned, throttle pipe lubricated, pressure looped both cables, original handlebars, original levers, everything's in mint shape. Tach and speedo cables were lubricated,
and tacks and speedo work beautifully. You can see it has 6,176 miles, perfectly clear gauge. It looks like a brand new gauge, mint shape. Tank is in beautiful condition. The tank was removed and cleaned with a special tank clean metal cleaning solution we use. Inside of the tank is spotless. The fuel petcock was needed to be replaced, so it's got a brand new fuel petcock on it, brand new fuel line, fuel filter, and the entire intake track, including the intake manifold, seals, clamps, carburetor, and filter, and air filter housing were removed. The carb was rebuilt. Actually, believe it or not, three times we had the carb off before we got it perfect. New intake seals, new intake clamps, and the ridges and original. Buddy, looks like Buddy's hungry. He got in here and got our Taco Bell lunch out of the trash. Little monster. The intake seals were replaced. The carburetor rebuilt three times. So it was perfect, and it runs beautifully. Fires right up, idles perfectly, doesn't backfire through the carb. Just a very rare commodity to have a shovel head run this good. So the entire carb system is like brand new and all original. Original air filter, which is really rare. That's one of the first things people would take off to put an S&S on there or whatever. Original exhaust system, exhaust gaskets, exhaust manifolds, exhaust bolts are in perfect condition. It's quite common for these to break off. These are perfect. Again, this is a 6,000 mile one owner bike. It's been babied since new. The bottom of the engine is as clean as the top. For a shovel head, it's extremely oil tight. Most of these are shovel heads are prone to leaking. I don't see any oil leaking anywhere out of it on the top end, but they are prone to sometimes weep a little bit. This is a super tight for a shovel head. The original Kickstarter has only been used a couple times by me. I don't think the previous owner ever Kickstarted it. Listen to this. It's like brand new, super, super tight, works beautifully. The original pegs are in great shape. Brand new Harley-Davidson battery was installed and a brand new battery cable. The entire electrical system was gone through. All the connections were cleaned, greased, and reassembled. So the electricals, everything works beautifully on the bike. The rear end of the motorcycle was dismantled. The original brake master cylinder was rebuilt. Brand new brake line was installed. The rear caliper, we have the original caliper that goes with the bike, but it needed to be rebuilt. The cylinder was seized, so we put a brand new master cylinder caliper on there, brand new pads. So the whole brake system on the back of the bike is brand new and it works fantastic. Original shocks are in mint shape, original wheels in great shape. The Dunlop tire was replaced with a brand new Dunlop Elite 2 raised white letter tire, rim band, and tube front and rear. Look, it still has the nubs on the tire. It has 10 miles on it, 10 test miles. Everything's original on the rear fender here, 100% stock, original saddle. This is the one area where there's a little blemish on the paint. We could have easily sent that to a paint shop or touched it up ourselves. We did not want to mess with the patina of the bike because this is one of the few sole survivor original stock AMF 77s. It's 40 years old and it's in mint original condition. And that's what, when you look at the pans and the shovels, the knuckles, that's what's bringing top dollar is the original bikes. And that's, this bike is original. This side of the engine, we removed the entire primary drive. You can see it was cleaned thoroughly. It's absolutely spotless. It doesn't leak oil at all. There's a brand new primary seal, brand new shifter seal. The entire shifter linkage here was all dismantled. The shifter mechanism, this going into the transmission was completely dismantled and cleaned, greased, lubricated. It shifts as good as a new bike. It shifts fantastic. Best shifting shovel head I've ever been on. Clutch is on point, perfect. Everything was cleaned inside there, the clutch plates, springs, everything's immaculate. And it was reassembled with all new gaskets. Everything's perfectly tight in there. The chain is in like brand new condition. It looks like a brand new chain. The sprockets look brand new. They are the original items, but they're in brand new condition. The original peg looks brand new. Fender strut is in beautiful shape. Original Yankee turn signals, no reproduction stuff. This is a 100% 1977 Harley Davidson here, other than the service items I mentioned, oil filter, oils, the brake lines and the tires. And I actually have a list of the parts that were put into the bike. Brand new brake fluid, brand new brake master cylinder gaskets,
master cylinder rebuild kits, 4 quarts of oil, oil filter, carb rebuild kit, brand new fuel, petcock, fuel valve, fuel hose, hose clamps, fuel filter, a brand new primary gasket, cover gasket kit, brand new primary seals, brand new shifter seals, brand new fork seal kit, fork oil, and fork rubbers, brand new Harley-Davidson heavy duty battery, brand new rear tire, rim strip and tube, brand new front tire, rim strip and tube, brand new rear brake line, brand new rear brake caliper, 4 bolts, I don't know what they were for, and 4 nuts, and a couple other miscellaneous service items. So basically I have a 3-page list of services that were done here on the bike. And it was major detail front to back. And again, super attention to detail was kept to not mess with the patina on this bike. There was no painting on the engine, no painting on the frame anywhere, no touch up on the paint. The only item that would put any paint was on the swing arm, and that was as a rust preventative measure because the paint had failed on the swing arm and needed to be repainted, so in a couple areas, so we just repainted the whole swing arm. So there you have it, an absolutely gorgeous, original, stunning Super Glide, 40 years old. This is a museum quality bike. There are a couple of museums that are interested in the bike. It's going up for sale. We're going to auction it off. We are going to notify those the buyers that we know that are interested in this bike. So we hope that it goes to a good home. Someone appreciates it as much as we do here at the New England Motorcycle Museum. If you've been following us on social media, you know we're raising funds to finish the 45,000 square foot main museum building, which we've put millions into and ran short on funds. We are going to complete it this year. We got $500,000 grant from the state to finish it, and it's going to get done. So there was a 2-year chasing period on to get this motorcycle from the original owner, and we had it for a year and a half. I hate to see it go, but it's $15,000 or so towards or better towards finishing the museum. So it's just a fantastic bike, and if you buy it and you want to leave it here on display in the museum, you can leave it as long as you like. If you want to take it, we can ship it anywhere in the country. We use Daily Direct. We ship about 30 bikes a month with them, pretty much anywhere in the country. For somewhere in the area, $500 we would take. Sometimes a little more, sometimes a little less, depending on where you are. But again, title's in hand, original one-owner bike. Fantastic riding bike, fantastic running bike, fantastic looking bike. Everybody who walks in here is like, wow, that's a beauty. You get compliments everywhere you go on this bike. The red graphic, AMF logo, Kickstart, shovel head, just a rare, rare commodity. So good luck bidding on the bike. If you have any questions, give me a call, 860-454-7024. We're here Monday through Friday, 9 to 6 at Kaplan Cycles and the New England Motorcycle Museum. So like I said, the proceeds are going to rebuild the museum. So you're not only buying a piece of fantastic moto art, moto history, you're also helping preserve motorcycle history through funding the museum. So good luck bidding on the bike. If you have any questions, give me a call, and I'm going to push this back into the showroom so everybody can drool on it for a little while longer while it's here. So good luck bidding on it. God bless America.